Hello students, in this session we will continue with the SQL. Here we will study how to represent pattern matching and arithmetic operations in SQL. First of all, we will study pattern matching. Like operator is used for pattern matching. So if you want to compare a substring or a pattern, you can use like operator. Along with like operator, we can use a percentage symbol or an underscore. If you are using a percentage symbol, it replaces one or more arbitrary number of zeros or characters, where an underscore replaces by a single character. We will see example. Retrieve the names of all employees whose address is in Houston, Texas. So we have to retrieve the name of all employees who are living in Houston, Texas. So we know address is a multi-valued attribute, so it may contain any other patterns or substrings along with Houston or Texas, like house name, house number, like that. So we have to compare the whole address with Houston, Texas. If it matches, it should be retrieved. The query can be written as select name from employee, where the condition is address like percentage Houston comma Texas percentage. That is, the percentage will be replaced by, or it can be replaced by, any arbitrary number of characters followed by the word Houston, Texas, again followed by any other substring in Houston, Texas. Even if it contains any details other than Houston, Texas, that will be counted and names of such employees will be retrieved. Another example is find the name of all employees who were born in 1950s. So the question is to retrieve the name of all employees who were born from 1950 to 1959. That is, from, if a person born in 1950 January 1 to 1959 December 31st, he should be counted. The query will be written as select name from employee where birth date like. 1950 is the given year in the question. So 195 will be the constant. Now the next digit can be from 0 to 9. Year can be from 50 to 59. Then next underscore will be replaced by either space or a hyphen. Then two underscores are given for month. Again space or hyphen. Again two underscore will be replaced by date. So we have an example is given. If the birth date is 1955-05-12, this underscore will be replaced by each of the character in the birth date. So this is how a pattern matching is implemented in SQL. That is, if you want to compare a pattern character by character, then you have to use underscore symbol. If you have to just check whether a pattern exists in the table, then you can use percentage symbol. Now, arithmetic operators can also be included within a query. The standard arithmetic operators which are using in query are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. It can be represented along with a select statement. We will see one example. Show the resulting salaries if every employee working on the product X project is given a 10% raise. So we have to show the increased salary of employees if a 10% raise is given. The query will be select e.name, where e is a tuple variable of employee, then 1.1 multiplied by e.salary. In the question, it is specified there is a 10% raise. So we have to multiply the existing salary with 1.1 as increased salary. So the new salary or calculated salary will be stored as increased salary in the table. So the new attribute name will be increased salary. From employee as E, work zone as W, project as P. Three tuple variables are created where the condition is SSN of an employee in the employee table must be same as employee SSN in work zone table, and project number in work zone table must be same as project number of a project table, and project name in a project table must be same as product X. That is the condition specified in the question. Another example is retrieve all employees in department 5 whose salary is between 30,000 and 40,000. The query will be select star, that is the attribute to be retrieved is not specified in the question. In the question it is given retrieve all employees, so we are retrieving all the details of employees. Select star from employee. Now the condition is where salary between 30,000 and 40,000. Here between is a keyword which we can use along with select statement. The term between and keyword, all these should be written as capital letters. Then another condition given is department number must be 5. Another example is retrieve the names of all employees whose age is between 30 to 45. The query will be select name from employee where age between 30 and 45. Next is ordering of query results. That is, if you want to get the tuples in the result of a query in a particular order of any particular attribute, that we can done by order by keyword. The order by keyword can be written along with select statement. We will see one example. Retrieve the names and salary of employees in department 5 ordered alphabetically by their names. So you have to retrieve the names and salary of employees in department 5, and the name and salary must be ordered according to the alphabetic order of their names. The query will be select name salary from employee where department number equal to 5. That is the only condition given. Now to make it in order, order by name, that is the attribute of which the tuple should be in order, that should be mentioned here. Order by name. By default, the tuples will be in the ascending order of values. It will be ordered in ascending order. If you want to get in descending order, the keyword will be des or DESC. So we can write order by des name. Then it will be in descending order. Next is insert command. Insert command is used to insert a single row or a tuple in a relation. The attributes must be listed in the same order of that specified in the create table statement at the time of table creation. One example, for a relation employee with attributes name, SSN, birth date, gender, salary, super SSN and department number. If you want to insert a row, the query will be written as insert into, here table name must be specified, insert into employee, then values within bracket, the name should be specified first, then SSN should be specified, then birth date, then gender, salary, super SSN and department number. So the values of attributes must be written in the same order that is specified in the employee table at the time of table creation. So this statement will insert one tuple into the employee relation. Now if you have written such a query, insert into employee values, only four values are mentioned here. other values are not written. So if such a query is written, the unspecified attributes will be entered as null value. So this is how each row will be inserted in the table. Now if you want to delete one or more tuples, we can use delete command. There we can specify the condition also in where clause. If where clause is not written, all the tuples will be deleted and the result will be an empty table. Then also the table will not be deleted, table exists as an empty table. If you want to delete the table, that will be done by drop table command that we will study later. So example, delete from employee where SSN equal to the specified number. So all the tuples which satisfy this condition will be deleted. Again, delete from employee where department number equal to 10. So the details of all employees in department number 10 will be deleted. In the third example, delete from employee. No condition is specified. So all the tuples from the employee table will be deleted. Table will exist as an empty table. Next is update command. The update command is used to update the values of one or more attributes in a relation. That is, if you want to modify the value of an attribute, you can use update command. Example, change the location and controlling department number of project number 10 to Bel Air and 5. So we have to update the project location into Bel Air and project number into 5. Sorry, department number into 5. The query will be update the table name project, set project location equal to Bel Air, department number equal to 5. That is a new value to be set. Condition is where project number equal to 10. So this is how an update query should be written. Update table name, set now the new attribute values, project location equal to Bel Air, that is a value to be set. Department number must be changed into 5, where condition is project number equal to 10. Another example is give all employees in department number 5 a 10% raise in salary. So the query will be update employee, set salary equal to, that is a new salary, salary into 1.1, 10% rise. Condition is where department number equal to 5. So here the new salary will be stored as attribute salary itself by multiplying it with 1.1. So this is how update operation should be done in SQL. Thank you. I hope the concept is clear. Now then the next session we will study nested queries, go through the examples and study well.